All right, Zach is a bassoon. We're going to commence the learning process. Zach, please open that box
this
within
box?
The bassoon case. Okay. Remove the bassoon reed.
Is that the reed?
That is the reed.
Okay.
I don't think you have to play dumb. Or do you actually not know that's the reed?
That's the reed, Zach. It's the reed.
Okay. You can open that and put it in the small glass of water over there so it will hydrate while you put together your bassoon.
Wow, that's smart, Paul.
Yeah.
Which end do I put it in?
The wood end into the water.
You mean the rosewood?
No, the other end, cork. The blowy, reedy
okay.
part, yeah. Technical information.
The business end.
Okay. So, probably sit down and put that on the floor in front of you, the case.
Right.
Carefully.
Careful.
Then you're going to want to remove the bottom part of the bassoon, which I believe is called the butt, which I'm going with because I can't exactly remember.
Big part.
Yes, that part. And you'll see on the end of it, there are two holes.
I do.
Those are where the two joints go, and they connect at the bottom through a U-tube, giving the bassoon its length. So I want you to reach down and pick up the wing joint, which is the shorter one.
The shorter one.
Yes. And find the smaller hole and twist it in so that that metal part at the very bottom goes over there.
Right.
It's a bridge key.
Bridge key.
Okay, now take the longer joint, which is called the long joint,
okay.
and insert the thinner end
uh-huh.
next to the wing joint
okay.
so that it fits together. You'll see there, look at it from the other side, I think.
Okay.
And if you twist it around so this side is facing you,
mm-hmm.
you'll see this rod needs to go into that small hole.
I see.
And it will lock it in place.
Okay, oh my gosh, how do I hold this thing?
You can put it down on the floor in between your legs if you want.
That's much easier.
Yeah, it's safe. It's fine. And then
okay.
fit the rod in.
The rod's in.
Okay. So, take the bell.
The bell.
That is the bell. And insert it on top of the long joint.
So like that small piece,
which is another bridge key, goes over that small piece of metal. You are almost done assembling your bassoon. Take the bocal, that piece that you blow into, out, and insert the cork into that hole on the wing joint at the top so that it's facing you.
Is this facing me? Or is it...
This is correct.
This is
how you want it. Yeah. So insert that cork into the hole in the wing joint, and then you want to twist it so this knob is covered by this pad.
I see.
When you let go of whatever it is you're holding down, or there's a key down there somewhere. I think it's the whisper key.
Oh, the whisper key. I
yeah.
heard about that.
Now, you are now ready to put your reed into your bassoon. But first, we're going to learn how to play on the reed. So close
okay.
that case and put it somewhere out of the way.
Do I need the strap?
Yes. Get the strap out.
Okay.
I was going to do the reed part first, but we might as well put the strap on.
Okay.
Grab the black straps. The red one's no good.
And what about this one?
That is optional. That's a hand rest. I like to use it so you can, if you want. You would twist it into
right
that,
here?
Yeah, that part.
Okay.
Facing with the thick end up. And it just gives you a place to rest your hand.
Okay.
You might have to loosen a little more. Eating up all my bassoon lesson time with this thing.
I know.
I think that's as far as it goes.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Oh, shoot.
And you just need to put the thicker end up and twist it in. And then for the strap, you're just going to unwind it and hook the metal hook on the end through the small hole on the bottom of the bassoon. I'm going to get this reed for you so you don't have to go waving the bassoon around.
Thank you.
Now, for a bassoon embouchure, how do you want to form that, Zach? You want to say the word how.
How.
Then you want to hold that. You want the
uh-huh.
pressure to be coming from the corners of your mouth, not from the tops and bottoms, because you'll squish the reed. So, got that set up fairly well. You're probably going to want a little higher, mm-hmm. so that you don't have to bring your mouth to the bassoon. You want it to be right in front of you.
It's piano benches.
Yeah, mm-hmm. not ideal. There you go.
I see bassoons do this sometimes.
There you go. Keep hiking it up there. That's good.
Is that good?
Yeah. So, take this reed, which is now properly hydrated.
Mm-hmm.
Say the word how.
How.
Put the bassoon reed in your mouth a good bit of the way. Yeah, and try blowing. There you go. You got a sound. Mess around with it a little bit. See if you can find a sweet spot. There you go. So try twisting that onto the vocal. Gently.
Is that good?
Yeah. Blow into the reed.
No key.
Just blow into it open for now. There you go.
Is that good?
Try taking a little more reed. Here. Yeah, see, that's honkier. So you want to find a sweet spot there. But for our purposes, that's good. So, here's what you want to do.
Right.
With your left hand, place your thumb on the whisper key
mm-hmm.
and your right finger upon the first tone hole.
Those
are tone holes. There aren't pads on the front. You want to get familiarized with where those are. I would use 1, 2, and 3.
Okay.
And just use the first finger now
mm-hmm.
and hold down the whisper key and that tone hole and nothing else and try playing that note. And then put down the second finger.
Right here?
Yep.
That second tone hole?
Yep. And play that note. And then put down the third finger and play that note. There you go. All that right. is E. This is the lowest one you just mm-hmm. played. D and C. So, if you play
mm-hmm.
the first one, the C, so one finger down, go down, go down, and do it again.
I see where this is going.
Yeah. And take it home. All right, you're a virtuoso.
All right.
Zach Whitson has just learned to play high cross buns on the bassoon. And I believe has been instilled with a lifelong love of music, which he will nurture for many years to come.
And for this last act, I will play the bassoon solo from The Rite of Spring.
All right.
I don't know how to play. you're
humming. Okay, so let's take it. Let's talk about how to take it apart
yes.
properly while we're here. So take the reed out, and you basically go in reverse order.
The reed?
Yeah, you want to slurp any excess fluid out of there.
Oh,
if you
I see
do some fluid slurping for me. And put it in this box so that it will stay dry.
Mm-hmm.
And then you want to take the vocal out, just carefully twist it out.
It's a little awkward to hold.
Yeah, and you'll just place it in that spot you can see for it in the bassoon case. And then
secure.
Take the bell off the top. You can put the bassoon back on the floor again if it's easier that way.
Yeah, it probably will be. Unhook this nonsense.
Yeah.
So afraid I'll break woodwinds when I dismantle them.
Yeah, you have to be a little careful with the rods and the pads or anything. The bell's probably
the bell.
Safe. So take the bell and put it in the shortest spot here in the front. Like that. It only fits one way, so don't be worried about that. And then you want to unlatch the long joint from the wing joint with that little thing you put down there.
Oh.
Yeah, that's okay. been holding those together. And then you want to take out the long joint.
Long joint.
Just be careful, but don't worry too terrible much about it. I would, yeah. There you go. Just twist it out in small motions. And you want to place it in the longest spot in the box.
Right.
And once again, it'll only fit only so if it's wrong, you'll know it's wrong.
Yeah.
And you pull out the wing joint.
It's awkward to hold.
Yeah, it is. It'll be fine. There you go. Place that in that spot at the very back. You might have to twist it around a little because it's shaped that way. There you go.
I think that's right.
There it is.
Yeah, there you go. And then remove the hand rest.
Oh, yeah. You didn't have to twist that much at all.
Put it in there. Place the butt in the case. And finally, place your strap and your reed in that small box there. Turn to the camera and say, I love bassoon.
I love bassoons.